I've drawn a simple relay here. Everything in red is wiring, basically. The blue is the moving mechanical switch. I use green for the positive sign and labeling loads 1 and 2. Black is just the box that the relay comes in. This right here. Let's start with disconnecting this. Right now there's no power actually getting to this coil, so nothing is affecting this blue piece right here. The power going through here will end up going to load number 1. Let's reconnect this. Now in order to make this picture accurate, I'm gonna have to move this blue piece. Now we have power going through this coil to ground, and we also have power going through here to load number 2. It's no longer powering load number 1. What happened here though? We used electromagnetism to flip a switch. When you run electricity through a coil, it creates a magnetic field. The more coils you have, or the more power you send through it, the stronger that magnetic field is. Cars only have 12 volts to work with, so you'll end up with a lot of windings to make up that coil. This blue piece here is made out of a ferrous metal, which means that it's affected by magnets. There's iron in it. Because it's a ferrous metal, it is affected by that magnetic force, and we pull on it to move it physically from one location to the other. Here's a real example of that. So when you're describing a relay to someone, what would you call all these circuits? This is your coil circuit, this is our normally on circuit, and this is our normally off circuit. It's called normally on and normally off, referring to when this coil is not energized. If you don't have this connected at all, this will still work as a circuit going from here down this way to circuit 1. So why use a relay instead of just a switch? Well, there are a lot of components on a vehicle that will draw a lot of amperage. This coil, however, doesn't draw a whole lot of amperage, so you can have a relatively weak switch turning this coil on and off. Then, the relay has to deal with the high amperage. The company building the car can use as beefy a relay as they want to, while still keeping the switches small and low amperage. Multifunction switches like your headlight switch that has on, off, auto, parking, sometimes even your fog lights are built into it. Those switches are possible thanks to relays like this. Also, your turn signal and wiper blade stalks. Those kind of switches would have to be a whole lot bigger to handle a lot of amperage. There are a bunch of different relays out there too. Like this one is a 5-pin relay. Sometimes they have a 4-pin relay where this line here doesn't do anything. Your normally on position won't have a pin connected to anything, so it'll only power something if your coil is energized. There are even solid state relays that don't have any moving parts in them. Those involve some advanced electronics that are beyond the scope of this video. You may have had to replace a relay at one point and thought, how does this thing fail? Well, there are multiple ways they can fail. One way is in the coil. These relays do exist to handle a lot of amps, and amperage can build up a lot of heat. Even without the amperage, sometimes these things are in engine bays and there's going to be heat cycles either way. Over time, the heat cycle may break the connection in the coil itself. As you can imagine, in order for that coil to work, that copper you see there isn't all exposed metal. It's insulated with a very thin layer of insulation, and you might get a coil that shorts out to another, and in this example you've only got 2 loops. That's not going to generate enough of a magnetic field to pull on this switch here, so your switch is going to be stuck in the normally on position even though power does flow through this. Another way these things can fail is on the switch side. You can get a buildup of junk right here. At some point that's going to stop the flow of electricity entirely, or it's going to build up enough resistance that whatever you're powering isn't going to get enough power. For example, it might make a light bulb look dim, or a motor might not turn as fast as it should. Luckily, whenever a relay fails, you just have to replace the relay. Replacing a relay is almost always a whole lot easier than replacing the switch that controls this coil, which is another benefit to having a relay instead of a high amp switch. I'm going to be using a relay like this in an upcoming project. I have some fog lights that have 2 color options, and I'm going to use this relay to switch between the 2 colors. And I won't be stuck always having a fog light on because another relay is going to control the power source to this. These will be the 2 different color LEDs, and this will be the power source coming from the on-off relay for the fog light. So if you want to see this information put into real-world use to make a custom lighting system, I'll have a link in the video description to that video when it comes out. If you've gotten this far, you should consider subscribing because I'm going to continue to make videos like this, and a bunch of other educational automotive videos. Thanks for watching, I'll see you in the next Car Simplified video.